Okay, students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing good. Okay, now as you know, we are doing the fifth chapter, right? And yesterday, in my previous video, I had showed you the iConnect part. That is, I had showed you about the nest, how the cuckoo lays the nest in the crow's bird. Yes or no? In the crow's nest. And the crow does not come to know that the eggs are not its. And when the baby is hatched from the egg, that time also the crow does not abandon the baby, but it brings up the baby like its own babies. Okay, so we had seen that how the cuckoo lays its eggs in crow's nest, and we also saw that how the crow was so kind hearted. Mother crows are very kind hearted because they bring the they know that it is not their egg, but still they take care of the egg, then they take care of the baby till it flies away. Understood? So in this story, what we are going to learn today, also we are going to learn about a kind-hearted priest. Now I told you what was priest yesterday. Priest means the one who does prayers in the church. Okay, as you have a pujari in mandir, in the same way, there is a priest in the church, the one who does prayers, the holy person, he is known as priest of the church. So today in this story also, we are going to read a story about a kind-hearted priest. Okay, so are you ready for the story? Come on, let's see what is there in this story. Okay, students, this is the second part of chapter 5th. That is, this is the second video of the fifth chapter. Okay, now let's see the textbook. Okay, students, so this is the I read section. Yesterday we had done the I connect section. Do you remember? Yes, and today we will do the next page. That is the I read section, and it is on page number 35. Okay, are you ready? Come on, let's start. Let's read a story about a priest who helped a sparrow family. So we are going to learn about this priest who helped a sparrow family. See, in the picture you can see this is a priest. This is a church. Can you see? So the holy man, it is a male, okay, who works in the church, who does prayers in the church. He's a holy person. So a male holy person of the church is called priest, and the female holy person is called a nun. You must have seen in movies and all, right? This is called a nun. They both are working in the church, means they both offer prayers in the church. So this is a nun and this is a priest. Okay, now let's see the story. An old priest lived in a little village in Spain called Santa. So this priest lived in Santa. Okay, one day the priest helper Maria burst into his room and said, "Sparrows are building a nest in your letterbox." I opened it, and what did I see? Bits of hay, paper, twigs and wool. So you know what happened? The priest helper was a helper, means one who does the work, all the work in the priest's house. Okay, her name was Maria. She's like a work lady. She does all the housework, as you have your helping maid, right? You have your maid. So she was also the maid of the priest. And one day, very fast, she came into his room and she said, burst means enter suddenly. See, here it is given in the word body section. The meaning of burst is enter suddenly. So suddenly she entered the priest room and she said, "See, there is a letter box." There was a letter box, okay, where the priest used to get his letters. Means everybody used to put the letters in the letter box. So you know what? What Maria said, do you know that sparrows are building a nest in your letterbox? So Maria said, the sparrows are building a nest inside your letterbox. I opened it, and when Maria opened the letterbox, she saw hay. Hay means dry grass, paper, twigs and wool. So all the things what birds use to make the nest, she saw it in his letterbox. There was hay, paper, twigs and wool. Then how did the old priest react? Now what was his reaction, that we will see. The old priest laughed and hurried off to look inside the letterbox. So he went fast. He started laughing and he went to see his letterbox. There he saw two busy brown sparrows. They were building their nest. So when he opened the letterbox, he saw inside there were two busy means they were doing something. The sparrows were building their nest. So they were busy and they were brown sparrows and they were building their nest. I know you, my little one, smiled the priest. So the priest told the sparrows, I know you, my little ones. He did not get angry on them that they are building nest inside his letterbox. But he said them that I know you, my little ones. And he was smiling. In a few days, you will have 3 or 4 brown eggs. When the eggs hatch, you will need 3 weeks to bring up your family. All right, I will make sure that no one disturbs you. So you know what the priest told the sparrows? That now you are building your nest. Yes or no? Then he said, within a few days, you will give eggs. You will lay eggs. You know why the sparrows build nest? The sparrows build nest to lay the eggs. So the priest said, now you will lay eggs. And then after your eggs hatch, you will bring up your family. Means you will bring up your, you will take care of your babies. Okay, so he said, you will need 3 to 4 weeks for this. To bring up your sparrows and all till the baby sparrows grow up. So he said, you will need 3 to 4 weeks. So he said, I will see that nobody disturbs you. So the priest said, don't worry, you stay in my letterbox. You lay your eggs, you take care of your babies, you do what you want and nobody will disturb you. Okay, the priest said, now nobody will disturb you. You can stay in my letterbox peacefully. Then what he did, the old priest carefully locked the letterbox. Then he closed the letterbox so that the sparrows are not disturbed. He did not take out the sparrows. He did not throw the nest away. But he was a very kind-hearted priest. So he told them to stay there and then he locked the letterbox. If I lock the letterbox, my little sparrows will be safe, he explained to Maria. So then he told Maria, see, you can see Maria in the picture. She was his helper. Means she was helping him in all his work. Okay, so then he told Maria that if I lock this letterbox, the sparrows will be very safe. The sparrows will be very safe. Okay, now we will turn to the next page. After a few days, only the father sparrow flew in and out of the letterbox. Then after a few days, you know what happened? Only the father sparrow, he was flying in and out of the letterbox. So the priest came to know that the mother sparrow is sitting on the eggs. So the priest came to know that the mother sparrow has laid her eggs and she is sitting on the eggs. Only the father sparrow could be seen flying here and there. So the priest understood that the mother sparrow is busy sitting on her eggs. A few more days went by. The priest bent down and put his ear to the letterbox. They are cheeping, he cried happily. The eggs have hatched. So after a few days, again the priest went to the letterbox and he just put his ear near to the letterbox. And what he could see? He could see the sound of chirping of the baby sparrows. He could hear the sound of chirping of the baby sparrows. And he became very happy. He said, yes, the eggs have hatched. Means eggs have hatched means the eggs have come, the babies have come out of the egg. So he was very happy. Now while the old priest was listening to the birds in his letterbox, an important meeting was taking place in the big city of Barcelona. Okay. So when the old priest was listening to the birds, okay, he was just listening to the sound of the birds. You know what was happening in Barcelona? Barcelona is another city. There was an important meeting taking place. Means even the priests have the meeting. All the priests of the different cities also, they have meeting. So there in the city of Barcelona, there was a meeting. The archbishop and some priests were talking about the old priest of Santa. Now, you know what is archbishop? See, it is given in the word body. Cheeping is also given. Cheeping means sound made by baby birds. An archbishop means head of all churches. Okay, so this is an archbishop. So he is head of all the church. He is the head. He is head of all the priests also. There are many priests in a city, right? There are many priests. There are many churches. So there are many priests in a city. So archbishop is the head of all the priests in the district. Okay, he is the head of all the priests. So he is the main priest. So they were having a meeting and they were talking about this priest. They were talking about this old priest of Santa. Okay, because he had become very old. So all these priests, they were talking about him. Now what they were talking? The priest in Santa is too old now, said the archbishop. We should send a young priest there instead. Now the archbishop is saying, now the priest of Santa has become very old. He's become very old. So now we should send a young priest over there. You know, when the priest becomes very old, then they send a young priest in his place. Because we have to do all the work of the church and all. Okay. So he said, now I will send a young priest over there. But the villagers love him, replied the priest. Let him work in the village for some more time. But other priests were also there, and now they are saying, please don't send a young priest over there, because all the village people, they love him very much. So please let him be there in the village for some more time. Okay. The archbishop thought hard. At last he said, I know what to do. I will set him a test to find out if he is too old. Now the archbishop was thinking what to do. Then he thought of an idea. He thought that I will set him a test to find out if he is too old. I will give him a test and find out if he is too old. I will ask him to come to see me in 3 days. If he comes, I will let him stay in Santa. If he does not come, I will send a new young priest to Santa. So you know what he decided? He decided to call the priest. He was writing a letter to him and he decided to call the priest. And he said, if the priest will come to me in 3 days, then I will not send another priest on his place. But if he does not come in 3 days, then I will send a new priest over there in Santa. Okay. So the archbishop picked up his pen and started to write a letter. So he has started to write a letter. Okay. You can see in the picture, he is writing a letter. Then what happened? The next day, the postman dropped the archbishop letter into the old priest's letter box. It fell to the bottom of the box and lay beside the nest. Now you know that the priest told that nobody should disturb the sparrows. Yes or no? So nobody was going to take the letters. So you know what? The postman kept the letter in the letter box that the archbishop had sent. And the letter was just lying near the nest. But nobody was going to take, because the old priest had told nobody should disturb the sparrow. So the letter was in the box. No one saw the postman who came to the bottom of the garden and put the letter in the box. And nobody saw the postman. Nobody saw the postman when he came to put the letter. If anybody would have seen, then they would have taken the letter. But nobody saw. No one opened the letter box because they did not want to disturb the sparrows. Okay. And nobody opened the letter box because they did not want to disturb the sparrows. For 3 weeks, the mother sparrow and father sparrow carried food in and out of the letterbox. So for 3 weeks, the mother sparrow and the father sparrow, they were taking food in the letterbox for their babies. The baby sparrows cheep louder and louder. And as the baby sparrows were growing, they cheep louder and louder. Okay, they were making more and more noise. Then one by one, they came to the opening of the letterbox and flew away. And you know, when the sparrows grow up, they learn to fly and they fly away. So one by one, the sparrows, they learn to fly and they flew away. The priest counted 4 baby sparrows. Okay. The priest, he counted 4 baby sparrows. He counted that there were 4 baby sparrows. The next morning, the priest went to the letterbox at the bottom of his garden. Now, the next morning, after all the sparrows had flew away, he went to the letterbox. Then, tock, tock, he knocked. There was no sound. But he was just knocking on the letterbox. But there was no sound from the letterbox. So he understood that all the sparrows have flew away. He opened the box and there were no birds inside. Okay. When he opened the letterbox, he saw that there were no birds inside. But a long white envelope fell out into the grass. But when he opened the letterbox, one envelope fell. The letter fell down on the grass. The priest opened the letter, and when the priest opened the letter, what was written? This came 3 weeks ago, he sighed. So he saw the letter and he was seeing the letter. The date was written. It had come 3 weeks ago. But nobody opened the letter box because the priest told nobody to disturb the sparrow. So nobody had opened the letter box. He sighed, you know, he sighed means it is given in the word, but he breathed heavily means he was very sad. Okay, he was very sad. He sighed. When you sigh means you say something very sadly, that is called sighed. But I did not open it. He said, it came 3 weeks ago, but I did not open the letter box. The Archbishop asked me to see him in 3 days. I have failed his test. Now he will send me away from Santa. Now he is telling that the Archbishop had called me to meet him in 3 days, but I did not go to meet him. Now he will send me away from Santa. Now he is saying, now he will send a young priest here and he will send me to some other place away from Santa. So he was very sad. A tear came to his eyes. He looked up and saw the sparrow family. They were sitting in a tree just above the letterbox singing happily. So he was very sad and even tears came to his eyes because he did not want to go from Santa. He looked up and he saw the sparrow family, and he looked up, there was a tree. And when he looked up, he saw the sparrow family, they were singing very happily. They were making noise very happily and they were very happy. Ah, well, he smiled. I must leave Santa, but at least I helped you bring up your children. Then he smiled. He said, no problem if I have to leave Santa. But I am happy that I helped you to bring up your children. But he was very happy that he had helped the sparrows. He had helped the father sparrow and the mother sparrows to help them grow up their children. Yes or no? He helped them to lay their eggs. He helped them to make their children big. Okay, so he helped them to grow in growing up of their children. If he would take out the nest from the letter box, if he would throw away the nest, then the sparrows would have not been able to lay eggs and no babies would have come. Yes or no? So he was very happy that he had helped the sparrows. No problem, he said, even if I have to leave the Santa village, still I am happy that I helped the sparrows. So this is the story. Okay, students, this is the story and it's a beautiful story. Yes or no? Okay, students, so we have read the story about the priest and we saw that he was so kind-hearted. He was such a good person. He helped the sparrows, but still he had to leave the Santa village because of that. Okay, so you know, sometimes you think that if you do something good for someone, then you are in problem. Okay, suppose any problem comes to you, then you think, see, now I will never do anything good. I don't want to do anything good for anybody, because if I do good, then also something bad happens to me. So this is not the thing, students. Even when you do something good for somebody, it will always come back to you. It will not come immediately, but it may come later on. Later on, even God will do something good for you. He will not do it at once. He will not do it immediately. He will not do it very fast. Okay, it is not that if you help someone, if you do good for someone, then immediately God will do something good for you. It is not that. He can do good for you at later on time. Later on also, you will get the fruit of your helpfulness. Okay, if you help others, you will always get its good result. You will always get its good fruit. Okay, so sometime when you help others and if you are in problem, then don't think that no, I should not help others. I am helping others, then also I am in trouble, or still problem is coming, still I am always getting in problem. So don't think that. So whenever you do good and if you are in trouble also, still you must be happy that you have helped someone. The same thing has happened with the priest. He did good, but still he had to go out of the village because he did not read the letter. But still he was not what he thought. No problem if I have to leave the village, but I am happy that I helped the sparrows. Yes or no? So it's always when you help others, when you do good for others, then it will always come back to you. It is not that. It may come later on also. Okay, later on also, God will do something good for you. So don't think that if I do good and if something is wrong, if something wrong happens to you, then you must not never think that no, now I will never do good. It is wrong. Okay? So be good always, always help. The person who needs your help, always take care of others, always be helpful and caring. Then others will also be good to you and helpful to you. Okay? So this was the moral of the story, that you should always be kind-hearted and helpful. Understood? So we have completed the story in this video. Now next video, we will be discussing the exercises of the textbook, like the checkpoint section, I understand section. Okay, students? So I hope you have enjoyed this story. You have learned something from the story, right? Okay, so thank you for watching my video and have a nice day.